Hey everybody, we're back. Right, so on this episode, I am going to try and start this vortex ritual. As I said, the areas always change depending on where the computer thinks you are weakest or they can spread your armies out far enough. So now that we took Sartosa, they're going to put it at Sartosa, Lothurn, our main capital, and the White Tower of Hoeth. So what we're going to do is
I'm ready.
Three turns from now, we're going to start the ritual. DY will still be recruiting for one turn, and then that should spawn some chaos armies up here, and he'll be able to come with this pretty nice army and hopefully defeat whatever is going to be sitting up here waiting for
us. Guides are at.
Also be aware it is important to make sure your other cities around the city that they're going to be coming for are well maintained, because they will definitely be coming for us as well as we have a great port, Elastor. We are going to take Tyrion and immediately take the Phoenix Gate. Oh, here we go. So we got some Dark Elves right there. Alright, so
servant of
looks like
king.
These guys are getting beaten down pretty good. Let's see what the Phoenix Gate has. It's a 20 stack in there. They got some Executioners, Blackguard and Aggarond. A couple Hydras, a couple Colwyn Lights. Okay, so they have a pretty good army there, but they don't have a lord. So hopefully we should be able to take that. DC just chilling. Let's go to our next turn here. Alright, Hexawaddle declared war on Aggarond. So basically Masamundi has declared war on Malekith's faction. Karan Kar, that is a Dark Elf faction, they've been destroyed. Alright, yeah, there's no way we're defeating this army with that garrison, so we're just gonna... Okay, so if that northeastern portion falls, either of the other cities, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and raise it. I'm not honestly worried about it at all. It's the least of my concerns.
Protector
at this point.
Of the Ever Queen. As you command, attack!
My
lust
it's
going to
be a tough
battle.
Battle, but we should be able to take it. What I am worried about most are those War Hydras and the Cold One Knights. Although pretty much everything in this army is pretty scary. Their Dark Shards have shields, so skirmish for skirmish is going to be kind of tough. Their War Hydras are going to be able to do some damage to our infantry, so we'll see. But as you can see, I mean, these Phoenix Gates, or these gates into Ulthuan were supposed to be really impressive in the fluff, and as you can see, pretty cool map. Oh, well, we lost 9 wins of magic set so far.
Heir of Anarion! Acknowledged!
Lovin Seaguard!
Eagle Claw!
Alright, so we're gonna focus all of our guys on one gate instead of multiple.
Lovin Seaguard!
Orders received!
And yeah, you know what? We're gonna put our infantry in front.
Lovin Seaguard!
Skirmishers in back. Take them off skirmish mode, put guard mode on so they don't run away. We will. Okay, so this is a hill, so we're gonna put our ballista on the hill. Pull our Phoenix back this way.
Tyrion
in the front. Mage back with the archers. Let's get this thing going. And we will have
ancestors.
Ulthuan.
Entering Ethuel.
Cast Soul Quench on these Dark Shards. Try and do some immediate damage to.
Acknowledged.
Pop that on Tyrion.
At once.
It's gonna give him damage resistance. Don't want him getting injured right away.
Eagle Claw.
I guess we should switch the Eagle Claw over to. Actually, what we're gonna do, we're gonna have the Eagle Claw shoot the Colon Knights. It's the Hydra's in the background.
Look out!
Seaguard start pelting these guys. Cast Apocalypse assigned to these.
As you say.
Oh.
Spellcaster.
Those swordmasters.
Lacoy,
heal them up a little bit.
Awaiting orders.
Okay, so we have our ladders up. Ooh! The Apotheos is not doing those guys straight off the wall. It's gonna go. So these swordmasters look like they're going down. It's to be expected when we have no siege equipment. So our swordmasters over here are on the wall. They should be able to make quick work of those archers.
Acknowledged!
Without fail! Seal! Might as well get up on that. Why aren't they getting on the wall? That was frustrating.
Lovin Seaguard!
Lovin Seaguard are doing a good job holding these guys in place. Send our Phoenix in here to help on our lines. Tyrion onboard as quickly as possible. We're sending out the Hydras, etc.
White Lion!
Striking form!
Onward!
Let Tyrion give a little bit of a leadership buff to these units. Right there.
Understood!
We'll also have Sunfei right there.
Very well. We will obey!
Okay, we want these swordmasters on the Black Guard and Aggron. They should do pretty well. And they are anti-infantry and armor piercing. Okay, the Phoenix look like they're doing their job. Helping to clean up.
White Lions! Attack!
Oh, we have the Harganath Executioners. That is not a super good fight for those White Lions to be in, but they gotta do it.
Swordmaster of Poeth!
Okay, we have a mage.
Scython, hear me!
Have her cast a fireball over here.
Ephua, bend to my will! Scython, hear me! Ephua, bend to my will!
Going forth!
Without fail, Asur, forward! Orders received!
Okay.
Loyal!
And as you can see, our ballista has been slowly picking off these cold ones, so that's good.
Lovin Seaguard!
Because they're tough SOBs. We will fire on these Blackguard and Aggron. We want to make sure we capture both towers as soon as possible. We're going to get our mage up here.
White Lions. Steel.
And have all of our infantry move in on these Black Arc Corsairs. Buff our leadership over here with Tyrion.
Ready.
Cast Fireball on these Blackguard and Nagaron. Ah, too close to the wall. Okay. We cast Apotheosis on those White Lions, as they're losing their melee. That'll help with the healing. Move everybody into those Black Guard. We just cannot get rid of these Black Guard and Nagaron over here. Pretty frustrating. Prior Convocation. I'm gonna do it. Nah, you know what? We're gonna cast an Arcane Unforging, which is strong against single combatants on this War Hydra. It's gonna be sitting there. Might as well. Make yourself a sitting duck. Must have miscast. Oh, there we go. There we go. Alright. So slowly but surely we are getting rid of all these guys on the walls. Very, very slowly but surely. Give Apotheosis to those White Lions over on that side. Like I said, those Blackguard and Nagaron are tough. They're not. There are no slouches in combat. Tyrion, another leadership buff on this side.
Swordmaster of Poets.
Targoneth Executioners are getting a lot of work done against our melee units, which is to be expected, to be honest. Blackguard are coming in on the backside on these Phoenix. That is not good for the Phoenix. One of our Seaguard is completely out of ammunition, so we're going to send him up the wall. As you can see, his ammunition bar is gone. Okay. The Dark Elves are retreating. Which is good. That's finally going to stop the tower from shooting the Lothern Seaguard, which are still just pouring in fire. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start raining down arrows on these Hydras. We will have the Eagle Claw. Yeah, you know what? Shoot the War Hydra. That's another Arcane Forging on that Hydra. See if maybe we can back up a little bit and this fireball will work. Because we need to get rid of these Blackguard and Nagaron as quickly as possible. They missed it yet again. Some healing and those White Lions.
White Lions.
Alright, so we're finally getting to the point where we are getting solid work done. We're gonna make these guys group 3 because they're out of ammunition, so they might as well be melee. Especially because they are Lothern Seaguard, so they can kind of do that. They can double as spear infantry, which is awesome. Another reason why I love them. What we're going to do is polish off these Dark Shards. Let's take all our melee, crush these guys. Once the Dark Shards are done, we're going to put our archers on the wall. And we're just going to start pelting inside the walls. And these Bolt Throwers should not be advancing like that. Alright, good. So now we're going to put the Lothern Seaguard on the walls. We finally have control of the wall. Oh! Of course, one infantry unit comes up and they start taking control of the tower again. Because they are the defender, so they get that nice bonus. But as you can see, we do not have control of the towers because these guys are up here, even though they're routing. And the AI plays that game pretty well. They play the micro game pretty well. I'm gonna have the mage sit out here, but I am gonna have Tyrion start going in. See what he can do against the Hydra.
Orders received.
We're going to have all of our infantry go up against these Hydras. As you can see, Tyrion does very well against the Hydra unit, especially when he's all buffed as he is right now. Okay. Mass shatter. Okay, well, I was not expecting that, to be honest. We didn't even touch their lord, but we'll take it. We did not lose any units, which is good. We kept up a lot of healing with our apotheosis. The Blackguard of Nagaron did really well at holding the line up on the wall. The Hargonath Executioners were getting a little bit of work done. You can see 33 kills, 51 kills, but... really, with all the buffs from Tyrion, as well as the experience ranks for our units, really made the difference. 156 kills for the top White Lion. 204 kills for the top Swordmaster of Hoeth. Just really, really solid.
A glorious victory. Search this place.
We are going to occupy.
The gods
are pleased. You want to occupy the gates whenever you can, because right off the bat, the garrisons are really, really good, which is a lore-friendly thing. They should be. Let's see. Okay, we're going to upgrade Angeriel to top level. We're still going to wait for Ball's Anvil to fully upgrade.
Protect the Everqueen.
All right. As far as Tyrion is concerned, research rate. Yeah, you know what? Never been to have more research. Let's see here. I will take... I mean, it's just the gate, so it's not that big of a deal. We'll just do tax rate. I mean, a little bit of income is better than none. We're gonna wait for the Vortex Ritual. Two more turns, I promise.
That'll be Everqueen.
We are going to keep Jimmy K here, because they do plan on attacking here. So, we'll leave that for now. DY is recruiting. And, yeah, we're good. I did not say this yet. I hope everyone is having a good day, night, evening, morning, weekend, weekday. Whenever you're watching this, I hope you are enjoying yourself. Tyrannach dissolved our trade agreement. That seems rather rude. We'll see why that is. Maybe they lost a tradeway to us? Yeah, so they lost a tradeway. So sometimes that happens where you lose a tradeway.
At your service.
And you're no longer able to trade with that faction. Which happens. Looks like the Dark Elves going right back to the Shrine of Cain.
So shield against the
that means... let's take Tyrion right back to him.
Denied.
And... I want to heal my
units. I never tire. Inspecting the garrison.
Okay. So I stopped Tyrion literally right on the edge of having attrition. Alright, so what is this? Construction costs. You know what, I have a feeling we're still going to be building a lot of buildings, so let's just keep going down the economic chain.
The heir of Anarion.
We'll worry about the military chains later. Alright, Ball's Anvil. Side skill points 4. Tyrion's mage. Yeah, we'll give her wound. She could be a little assassin mage. We will learn regrowth. This gives your units physical resistance and an increase, increase in replenishment while in battle. So that's really cool. We'll take Shem's Burning Gaze. We're also going to take, we don't need exorcism just yet. We're not fighting any undead. So we will take the Net of Amentok. That does, eventually when we get down to the third level of spell, you can use an Area of Effect net spell. They nerfed it for Total Warhammer 2. It used to be an Area of Effect spell for every single level of the spell. Now, it's only for the highest level of the spell. So, if you're taking a Light Magic Wizard, just be aware, Net of Amentok, you need third level before you can really use it. I would say, I mean, you could use it effectively on one unit, but that's only like heroes or big monsters. Look at this. Was not expecting this, boys. What do they have? Ugh. Alright, well. I mean, we're gonna fight it just for the sake of the fact that auto resolve with the computer, this army would absolutely crush us, but we're gonna see what we can do here. They have a lot of dark shards. It's a lot of ranged units, and they have dark riders with repeater crossbows. So there's also skirmishing cavalry, which are extremely fast. So that is not a fun battle for us, but you know what? Gosh darn it, we're going to do our damnedest. So. Alright, so we will have our ballista over here, pouring in fire as much as they can. Gonna make it as tough for him as possible, really. That's the name of the game here. We're gonna be fighting uphill. Also gonna spread our archers as thin as we can to get the maximum amount of volleys off. Or, you know what I'm talking about. The spread and where they can shoot. These guys, we're just gonna have skirmish once they get to a certain point. And the Great Eagle, I mean, we can already see where they're deploying. So, and they don't have any artillery, so we have ranged advantage. So, really, this is just to kind of soften them up. I do not expect anything grand out of this battle. I didn't even know this guy was here. So, you know what? That serves me right for ignoring a whole side of my campaign map. Maybe I'll go ahead and make military alliances with all of those other high elf factions then too. Okay, Bolt Thrower getting some work in, which is good.
White Lions! It will be done!
Put everybody on guard mode.
A pace.
Going to skirmish those dark shards. They have shields, so it's gonna be hard to do damage against them with any ranged units, but better than nothing. Gonna keep pouring in fire from our ballista if we can. Looks like our ballista has lost line of sight. So our Illyrian Reavers are pulling some of their units away, which is good. That's kinda what we want them for. Dark Riders with repeater crossbows. Can't really see them that well, but there you go. Pretty neat looking unit. They have runes of Cain carved on them and stuff. Cain is the Elven god of war, blood, bloodshed. I should say not blood.
White lions! Understood!
I don't know what they're doing.
Without question!
We will obey!
Trying to whittle us down, I guess. But, I mean, we just keep shooting them, too. And they're shooting at our white lions, which have missile resist, so that's kind of an odd choice. Our Illyrian Reavers are getting wiped out, which, to be honest, was expected. Alright, time for the countercharge. Let's get to it. Let's get at it. We're going to send our Great Eagle in here against some of these Dark Shards. Alright. And this is just kind of a let it ride situation. We're going to send our Great Eagle after any ranged unit we can. Oh, look at that High Elven front line. Yes, 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 yes. And we're going to pull our eagle out because he's going to get start to get fired on by those guys. We'll send our ballista that way. Okay. Don't know why I have those spears attacking the board. That is a mistake on my part. The white lions are coming back. These guys are just getting just pelted. What's my eagle doing? I'm like, dude, go do something. White lions are back. I mean, it's just too much skirmish, really. That's what it came down to. They just kind of spam skirmish units. And we just didn't have enough to take them down. Especially because they had shields, so our skirmishers really weren't doing much, if any, damage to them. And then the Black Arc Corsairs are anti-infantry, so... you know, one of them got 103 kills, it's just melting face. So. Please, I can't lie, don't raise it. Okay, you could sack it, that's fine, to be honest. I'm okay with that. Alright, this... It's kind of giving us a chance, and I feel like it'd be... Oh, God. Alright, fine, we'll fight this one too. I hate fighting hero units. But I have an idea. Not saying it's gonna work. Why am I not? Revenge of the Druki here, guys. My goodness. Alright, so. They don't have much, but what they do have is very strong. There are really no hills or anything, so this is kind of a straight up forward pitch battle.
As you say,
we have our front line. Skirmishers right behind them.
We will obey.
We do have skirmishers. So, what I am planning on doing is we're going to skirmish the hell out of those Dark Shards. Even though they have shields. Put the spearmen on nice big block infantry.
Without fail.
Put them on guard mode. Take skirmish
off. Noble.
Put the noble right in the middle. Alright, we're just gonna micro our
Pull the Ever Queen.
Micro our infantry cav. Let's get a good look at these guys. They do look awesome. So they're gonna start shooting back.
Asa, a advance.
So we're gonna start moving. As soon as they shoot, we move.
Quickly now.
Like float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Following orders. Quickly now.
That's exactly what we're. That's.
We away.
And as you can see, not only does it take away their range from attacking us, but it's taken away that Spearman unit as well. And they got some good shots off there. As you can see, our Illyrian Reaver's kind of melting. But now here's what we can do. Melee mode, boom. Right into him. Right into him. Lothern Seaguard just melting these Black Art Corsairs. Get him. This beautiful charge, yes! Druki bodies flying everywhere.
All right, it shall be done.
And
for order. Excellent.
Very well. Loyal. Gloria.
All right.
Odious Druki.
Lothern Seaguard.
As you say,
take our Lothern Seaguard and put them in melee mode too and just dive in on these guys.
Moving
up. Take two of them. We'll start shooting that lord.
Make Oathwan proud. Quickly now.
Gonna pull our Illyrian Reavers out because the Spearmen are coming.
Defending
border. Go.
Moving out. Quickly now.
Lord is pretty tough. Apparently, if you can take that much missile fire. So,
orders received.
Yeah, just
kill
focus
them
on the other guys.
Without fail, moving out by your command. It shall be done.
Oh, those are the Spearmen. Those
orders
are the Spearmen. Do not want to fight those guys. Yeah, we'll kite those guys around.
Lothern Seaguard.
We will
to battle
fire on those guys.
For duty.
On me! Quickly now!
Lothern Seaguard with shields, fighting their skirmishers. We want a unit of pretty damaged spearmen, routing units. That's what we want. Want our Illyrian Reavers doing exactly what they're doing. Okay, we have everybody else tied down. We are skirmishing these spearmen. As you can see, they're slowly dying. There's one unit model down. Okay, our noble is doing very well. The elven nobles are pretty solid in melee.
Keep
chasing
order
your unit. Yes.
We're
gonna take down those guys. All right. So here's what we're gonna do now. We're going
as
to
you say, by your
take
command,
these Lothern Seaguard.
By your command.
We're gonna take that noble. We're gonna take these spearmen and send them that way because they are low on health, so they no longer have the martial prowess. And what I'm hoping to do here is shatter this army on army losses alone. Okay, Illyrian Reaver's still kiting the spearmen. There's a shatter. That's good. That is definitely good for us. A shatter is always good. The more shatters, the better. Okay. That hero's still running. This hero looks to be... she is gaining morale. Spearmen are getting kited to death, and they are nowhere near the battle. Our noble is doing quite well against their Dreadlord. It's a high, dark elf lord, by the way, if you did not know. Okay. Nice shot of these guys getting taken down. Okay, there's a shatter. And there we go. Alright, we have the mass shatter. So, a lot of the time, it's actually easier, especially when you don't have, you have superior unit numbers, but you don't have superior lord and heroes. You can see their lord got 130 kills, but it didn't matter because we just shattered the rest of their army. So, able to do that with the last army because they just had too many skirmishers. Too many skirmishers with shields. We will take. Okay, so now this Scourge of Cain Lord is going to get wiped out by Tyrion.
And what brings you here?
Yeah, I'm going to start taking out the Druki. Where is this guy? I don't even know where this guy's at. Odd. Where is he? Where did he pop up? No, I don't want to join. No. That Dark Brotherhood is south of us. We don't really need to worry about that. We have enough going on. This guy's probably just gonna come. Try and take towards the thigh again. Won't cost us any population, so we'll do it, but that's really frustrating.
Prince of Alphwa.
Okay.
Defender of the Phoenix Throne.
Lord Master, we'll give him the last point in Earthblood, and then Evasion. 5 melee defense, 6 speed. Never a bad thing to have fast spellcasters.
Okay,
Tyrion's about to put this guy to the sword.
Bring me battle!
Yo,
you. For Alaria, my queen.
Mobile amulet, it's going to give damage resistance. We can give that to one of our other lords.
Ever,
okay.
Lord. Attack!
And then we're going to take Tor Anlek.
Sealed!
Yeah, we're just gonna start taking every Dark Elf holding we can.
Defender of the Phoenix Throne.
Let's see. We will take. We're gonna take this. It's gonna give us armor for our higher tier infantry. We're gonna need the battles to come here. Ooh. Alright, cool. The Invocation of Vol. There are 4 powerful magic items at your disposal. Which do you choose? So we can have the Reaver Bow. That's pretty good. That's pretty... pretty nice. Okay, the Jewel of Dusk. It's a magic. That's a pretty nice armor. Alright, we're going to take the Crown of Authority. We're just going to give it to one of our other heroes. Lords, I should say.
Your word.
Fan.
Loyal to a fault.
Now you have the Helm Cane. But what you can get is the Noble Amulet. DY is going to be fighting a lot of battles soon, so we want him to be buffed out. It's got the Armor of Destiny already. So we will give this crafted armor to DC.
Protector
DC is going to have to start fighting some battles.
Their skill is legend.
So,
your decree.
All right, one more turn.
At your service.
In fact, no, we're gonna keep DC here because Lothern is guaranteed to get attacked.
Raised.
I did promise you we'd start the vortex ritual this turn. Probably not the best idea, but we're gonna do it anyway because I am a man of my word. We're gonna take the Valor of Aegis. He's going to get added weapon strength against basically all evil, evilly aligned races. So, Greenskins, Skaven, Dark Elves, Beastmen, Chaos, and Norska. Oh, guys, I don't want to do this. This is so anti-me. Now it's going to put it at Injurio. That's actually easier. Fine. Let's just do it.
The ritual is underway, my lord. Even working together, it will take your greatest adept some time to complete. Such is the ritual's power that the great vortex itself distorts under its pull. Be wary, though, for while the vortex is weakened, the forces of chaos will slip into this world.
Chaos spawned all the way in the middle of nowhere. All right. Ritual of the Seafarer. The preparations are complete. At the selected ritual sites, the wave fragments gathered at such cost from dark resting places across the world lie now beneath the outstretched hands of your mages. As one, they throw their heads back in incantation swelling with arcane power, echoing the aeons-long chant of the Archmage Kalidor, father and prisoner of the Vortex. With ritual words rise wisps of energy, coalescing into beams arcing through the heavens, channeling pure force to the Vortex. It falls now to you to protect the ritual sites until the ceremony is complete. Let's do it, man. See, I did not swear. I'm just super pumped. Alright, so we have 111 stack, 113 stack, and then we can't even see these guys down here. Good luck getting through the Neckarch Brotherhood. That's all I gotta say. Jimmy K should handle those guys no problem. And I'm sorry about that. Jimmy K should handle those guys no problem. And Chirilli isn't even under attack. So, alright guys, bonus all around. Bonus all around. We really, honestly, I'm more worried about these guys. So, what I'm going to do is... okay, so TY is recruiting those Phoenixes. And the turn, we'll see. We'll see what the Dark Elves over to our west do. We might have some rebuilding to do on our west side over on Kalidor. Ooh, Dark Elf Intervention Army. Interesting. Oh, and they attacked the Glittering Tower, where there's two stacks of armies instead of Lothurn. That honestly is probably going to wind up being an auto-resolve, guys. But as you saw, right away, Dark Elf Intervention, the Dark Elf was like, nah, homie, I'm not cool with the High Elves beating us to the Vortex.
Defender of the Everqueen. I will lead the Asa.
Get out of here. Didn't even lose
the
a unit.
The greater God Brother will avenge us.
Take the unit experience because we are garrisoned in a fortress, so we're going to gain replenishment back really fast. Okay. And let's see here. I don't know. Oh, okay. So he's going for Sartosa. He's coming from the mainland. I'm going to let them come to me. I'm going to leave Jimmy K here for now. Honestly, Sartosa by itself, without Jimmy K there, could probably defend it. But I'm not going to take any chances. There's no reason to. This guy bothers me. So let's see what we can do against these guys. Absolute trash. Shrine of Cain. I'm going to upgrade your walls. I do not want to lose the Shrine of Cain. That's a good place to get the Waystone Fragments. That's what we need.
Servant.
Tor Anlek.
Retreat.
Really? You're going to make me fight this? Alright.
I am ready to fight.
Again, they have it so low in our favor because of the fact that we have no siege equipment. Yes, it is a smart thing to bring a siege equipment, but when we're doing kind of blitzkrieg against the Scourge of Cain like this, we cannot afford to waste turns taking siege equipment. So, you cannot refuse my challenge. You cannot outrun me. You cannot beat me. Your last earthly sight will be your own innards as I offer them up in honor of the gods. I know I said that last time, but man, Wulfric the Wanderer, as soon as Norska comes back to Total Warhammer 2, you know we're doing a Mortal Empires campaign with Norska. That's just a given. I love that faction to pieces. Alright, so let's see, okay, we gained 6 wins of magic. That's awesome.
Shield of the Everqueen!
Swordmaster of Hoenn!
Some other melee units. Clump them up a little bit. Not that much. About like that. Put all our ranged right behind him. Gonna put him on guard off skirmish.
Swordmaster of Hoenn!
Did not need to do that.
Lovin Seagar! Swordmaster of Hoenn!
No. You know what? We want them chasing routing units. I'm gonna put Tyrion right in front. It's Tyrion had skirt. Tyrion had skirt, nothing. We are going to take our ballista and put him slightly off to the side. So we can just start raining in damage immediately. We're going to do multi-shot. They have no large units, so it's not something we are concerned about in the least. Let's do this thing. Nope. I want you to climb the walls.
We will obey.
Let's see.
For our ancestors, acknowledge as you say.
Alright, so we're gonna do that. We're going to send Tyrion in. Boost morale might as well. Right away, might as well. Sun Fang. You know what? Let's cast it right there. Yeah, that looks nice. Right in the middle of those units that are just sitting there waiting to be picked up. Gonna do some damage resistance.
It will be done.
Come on, man. Start shooting. What are you doing?
Spellcaster.
All right.
Go away.
Go ahead, up your power reserves. We're gonna do Patios to send these Swordmasters Poeth. We want our Swordmasters Poeth to survive for as long as they can. Units. I'm not a fan of losing units. I will do what I have to, but I don't like to. We will cast Val's Anvil right here. Watch this. Watch this spell. So this is because we have that right going, and it's just boom, just immediate destruction. Love it.
Eager for battle.
Right, I wonder why you're getting attacked. I told you to attack the game. Alright, so take these guys off lock. We're gonna shoot the Death Hag. Our melee units are all up on those walls. It's fantastic. We want our mage up. We want her to be casting Apotheosis on those Swordmasters of Poeth. They are very damaged. And we are going to send our Phoenix in against these range units here.
It will be done. White
our boys have taken the wall over there, so we're going to send them in
without
here.
Fail.
We're going to start pouring in. We're just going to start pouring in.
Loyal. Orders received.
We're going to send all our Lounder and Seagard to start shooting the Black Guard in the background. Clearly are giving us the hardest time than our executioners, and I don't believe they have any executioners. So, yeah, I mean they're just getting smoked by our range. These Swordmasters are just like holding the wall, which is awesome. We're gonna send the mage against the wall because why not? It's kind of fun. By the way, never send your mage against the wall unless it's something like this one. Like it's clearly just at such an advantage that it's
Alright.
We don't want to start hitting our own guys, so what we're going to want to do is we're going to put all of our... Oh, there you go. There's the Mesh Shatter. So they didn't even get Murder's Prowess. I don't know, again, I don't know why they had that as such a close battle when... I mean, you could look. They got a total of 177 kills, we got 737. So MVP of that one was definitely the Lawther and Seagard with shields. Nicely done, boys, nicely done. Ballista did some work.
Ancestors be praised. Okay. We have
captured
it.
For sure. Confident besieger. And this is again what I was talking about with the new trait system in Total Warhammer 2. He gains plus 5 leadership when laying siege to battles, and then you can actually scroll over and see, hey, you know, what are the buffs and debuffs. So he can only get siege expert, which gives plus 7 leadership when laying siege, which is actually a huge bonus.
Of Elf One.
Who is Jimmy K? Jimmy K. Jimmy K. What are we going to do with you, bud? You know what? We're going to give you an expiring presence, and we're going to start... Yeah. We all know Jimmy K wants to be the Bowmaster. That is true.
Ever Queen.
That is just a fact of life. You block army.
Defender of the Ever Queen.
Let's see. This is DY. DY, look. Everybody knows you're a merchant lord. Okay. Always trading, always negotiating. It's your thing, dude. Just
Your decree.
Just live it. We're gonna give you Earth Blood, as well as Evasion.
Defender of the Everqueen.
We're going to max out the Net of Amatok so we can give that an AoE effect. We are not going to use any population because next turn we'll finally be able to upgrade Fall's Anvil all the way. That is going to be a huge, huge, huge buff for us. And let's see. We need to go all the way back up to Tyria and see where we're going to hit next. So we can take... We can't just keep going that way. Alright, so we're going to take Tordrano. We're going to come back around. Take this over here because it looks like the Druki are starting to take land over here. Albion. What's Albion? Oh, God. Albion has a very, very low public order. Six turns. That's not going to be long enough. Oh, well. Well, I mean, we're probably going to lose this territory before Tyrion gets back over there. If we do, like I said, I'm raising it to the ground. I'm not wasting time with this area anymore. It's just annoying me at this point. For the High Elven campaign, since it's mostly islands, and I don't like to continually... Oh, God. Well, the Scourge Cain just confederated with Nagarond, which means that is Malekith's faction. So they just got significantly stronger. Cool, cool, cool. Well, that's what happens when you mess with your uncle that's like 600 or 700 years older than you, I guess. Alright, unite local nobility. If only they could stop squabbling amongst themselves, then we would truly be invincible. So, reduce construction costs and time for all industry and resource buildings for the High Elves. It's pretty sweet. There it is. Alright, we're going to upgrade Fall's Anvil. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing. Alright, let's see what we're doing with Tyrion here.
No.
Okay, I champion could care less about a two-stack army. Ugh, guys. What's the population surplus need to be? 4? Well, Torian, like, is, yeah, it's well defended.
Ready to serve. By Asurion.
Take Tordranil.
To victory. By lust for battle.
Occupy, for sure. Pleased. All right, we have Nagarite, the province. We are going to boost, let's see, province effects. Uninhabitable climate, so public order. Construction costs, construction time. Don't have to worry about untainted. We're gonna worry about... Oh, they don't have a public order one? Ugh. Alright, well, we're gonna increase growth so that we can get to our Anlek to get some walls.
What orders?
Tyrion, we're gonna just make you a beast in melee combat. It's time. He was a beast in melee combat in the fluff, and he should be now. Alright, Sartosa.
The Aster needs
unresolve. My strength grows. Thank you. Okay. And now Jimmy K can go start wiping out some troops in the north.
Guardian of the Phoenix Crown.
Okay, we're going to give his noble a Great Eagle. We are also going to give his noble the Valor of Aegis to increase weapon strength against Dark Elves. Because that is, so Jimmy K is going to get this and then just head straight north and do kind of a pincer with Tyrion.
I serve the
Phoenix. DC straight chilling.
Command me.
DY.
Tempt me not.
DY, let's meet these guys in open combat.
Back!
Beautiful. Well
a
fought,
noble
well
victory.
Fought. Okay. So that replenishment is done.
Phoenix throne.
And we are going to send DY in this direction to take out the Dark Elves that way. So,
all set.
DY, we're going to give you a barded Ithilmar steed. If you see over here on the left-hand side, top left corner, character stats. He's gonna gain, he gained 700 health, 17 armor, doubled his speed, reduces melee attack by 5, reduces weapon strength by 40, but also increases charge bonus by 50. So it's really, really, actually a really nice trade for him. We're also gonna give you lightning strike just in case you run into multiple stacks.
Elf one triumphant.
Okay, and your light wizard. We're gonna do Foz protection. I like Foz protection actually a lot. It's, you know, gives you a plus 30 armor and plus 27 melee defense, and it's AOE when you get to the third level. So you can't really beat that.
You may
DC can probably start recruiting an army. But we're gonna wait. We're gonna wait.
Glory to the king!
Alright, as you can see, we have 8 turns left on our ritual. Ugh. Alright guys, one more battle, then we're calling it for the night. We're gonna fight this one. I think we can win this one. If you saw, we do have a lot of Lothar and Seaguard with shields. They have only one Dark Shard with shields. The rest, they have infantry. High Elf infantry is pretty good. Those Black Arc Corsairs are going to do really well against us, but we're going to try and make it work. And yes, we're back on this map. I love this map when it comes to defending. Obviously, the AI doesn't really know how to handle it, but hey, if you do, then it's awesome. So now what we can do this time, since they don't have any artillery, we're gonna hide our skirmishing cav back. We'll put them over in this side. The AI tends to stack this side for some reason, and we can actually hide our great eagle as well. So we're gonna hide our great eagle back here. We're gonna hide our skirmishing cav back here. Actually, we're gonna, right from the very beginning, we're just gonna have them pot shot people. We're going to take 3 of our Lothar and Seaguard from there. Put 2 here on this ridge. Snuggle in, guys. Snuggle in. There you go. Yeah, I said snuggle. Put unit 6 over here. Put unit 2 over here.
Acknowledged.
And that gives us a strong center and a strong left edge. And our noble, we're going to slap right in the middle, just like last time. So let's do this. Let's kite the hell out of some of these units, huh? I just want to get a close-up. I love cavalry until forever. I think they did a great job how they look. There we go. Just getting some pot shots into there. They will kite those guys all day long. So there's one group of Black Arc Corsairs just basically taken care of, to be honest. Oh, right. We need to take skirmish mode off. Guard mode on. Guard mode on. Okay. How on earth they let the Black Arc Corsairs catch up to them? They're getting shot by someone or something. Do they have them? Oh my goodness, they have a ballista. Alright, well, we're sending our eagle out there then. I did not know that, guys. I apologize. I was not paying attention. Oh. Who's that? What is that? What is that? Is that a lord? A lord? Boom! Alright, get out of there. Oh my goodness. Casting spells on us? Alright. Yep, and that unit is basically dead. Nicely done. Skirmish calf. Skirmish calf for the win, baby, for the win.
Loven Seagar.
You know what? Let's do it.
Attack!
No use in waiting, guys. No use in waiting.
I am ready.
I told you to attack, guys. What are you doing? What are you doing? Get in there. Assassin, that's why. Oh my goodness, they have Spellcaster. Yeah, so let's just get in here.
Northern Seagull.
Start shooting these dark shards. Yeah, because our melee should envelop these guys. And then you know what? We can send our Green Eagle after their Dark Riders with shields.
For duty, by your command.
And what we're gonna do is we're gonna attack their mage, because I don't want their mage to keep pot shotting spells on us. And we're also gonna have guys, I'm all over the place with what I'm doing with my units here. Stop that charge. Get the Great Eagle into him.
I am ready.
Oh my goodness gracious. Oh my goodness gracious, that hurts so bad.
Noble Horn!
Come on, take out these Blackheart Corsairs, please. Great Eagle's doing their job. Please just kill these guys. I mean, there's 19 of them left. How hard is it? Thank you. Yeah, just get in there. Stop skirmishing.
Alright, so...
Let's shoot these Blackheart Corsairs because they're doing a number on our infantry. Attack this mage. Might as well. They're gonna be so bold as to move their mage up like that. You better believe we're gonna try and take advantage of it. This noble cannot lose his morale. That is not no way. Oh, it's gonna slow me up with spells. Just absolutely wrecked. Look at that. How do you have that many spells?
For duty.
How are you casting the one hitting you in the face? That's the mystery. Somebody needs to look that up. How on earth?
Black eye! A pace! Seal!
It will be done! Acknowledge! To battle! Order must be received!
Alright. Keep that mage running.
Serve the king.
God, we know they've done enough damage.
Without fail.
Yep, keep shooting the Blackheart Corsairs.
For duty.
Where's this guy? He's getting shot by that lord. So we're gonna take our noble back.
Pull back.
Kill this mage, please. Alright, we need to start taking care of this dreadlord. Oh my goodness, guys.
It shall be done.
Cannot be taking all the skirmish fire.
Loyal! A pace! For order!
Understood!
Kill them!
Just shatter already.
Advance.
We're gonna keep our lord right back here to get the morale buff. How has this mage not had any more damage done to them lately?
Yes!
That's what I want to know. Like, you've had a Great Eagle attacking you with its talons for the past God knows how long. Thank you. Finally killed it? Alright.
Northern Sea Guard.
I don't know how these guys still have,
Awaiting orders! Understood!
Oh, yeah.
Without question!
For our ancestors!
Loyal! Advance!
Move away from that spell, please. Advance! Didn't work.
For our ancestors!
Okay.
Draw back!
I'm just gonna...
Acknowledge!
Do melee.
To the fray!
Dark Charge, please. Father and Seagard should have no problem taking out that Reaper Bolt Thrower team. Okay, good. Spearmen are doing well. Great Eagle is getting in on the action over here on this Lord as well.
It will be done.
K-Knight Assassin is trying to kite our Father and Seagard. Just to be honest, okay. Should be attacking them. Should be attacking them. I don't know why you're not.
Understood.
Please attack them. I don't know how else to ask you.
Spearmen.
Okay.
For the Ever Queen.
Yeah. If we can get this Lord.
Yes!
Come on. Do not let him escape. Or her. It's a her. Can't tell. Shattered. Okay. And that should lead to a mass shatter.
Quick time.
Right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I love this map for defending. Alright, win one for the home team, guys. Okay, well, I know this has been a very long video, thank you for tuning in. If you watched the whole thing, I applaud you. And I appreciate your time. Thank you for watching. I think we've done pretty well here. And, you see this quote here? It is better that every high elf be condemned to hell than that idiot king plague them any longer. Kill him. Kill him for the good they know nothing of. So that is Malekith in a nutshell. Basically thinks he's just better than everyone else. So, kind of a dick. Guaranteed next video that guy's on top of our list of targets. By the way, guys, I think we did, you know, really good job wiping out those armies as quick as we did. We are going to leave them be, take the growth. Alright guys, well thank you very much, I appreciate it, have a great night, sorry I kept you so long, thank you for sticking with us, and next time we'll have some more battles, hopefully some more victories against the Druki. Have a good night, bye.